Hi friends, I am Dr. Rahul Kulkarni. I am a consultant medical oncologist practicing at Pune. Now this is the second video in our cancer awareness video series. In the first video, we had discussed about the basics of cancer and the various cancer treatment modalities. Now in continuity to the first video, in this second video, we are going to discuss about the cancer education system in our country and the need or importance of cancer specialized training. And this will help you to understand or know your cancer specialist better and to choose the right treatment plan for your loved ones. Now, why this is important? First thing, why it is important to know your cancer specialist better? This is because the best chance for getting the maximum benefit out of any anti-cancer treatment modality is the first chance. When this chance is gone, then you might not get a second chance with the same intent of treatment, or maybe the same treatment modality may not be possible at a later date. And that is why, as I've said in the first video, the first step in the cancer treatment management is to define the intent of treatment and to formulate a systematic treatment plan right at the beginning and also at each and every step of cancer treatment. And this is best done when it is done with conjugation or in a combined treatment modality plan or a multidisciplinary tumor board discussion with the involvement of all the three cancer specialties, that is medical oncology, surgical oncology and radiation oncology. Unfortunately, in our country still, the cancer patients continue to be treated by healthcare professionals which are not adequately trained in oncology, and that can sometimes compromise the treatment outcomes. So this is not ideal in the current era of super specialization or current era of advanced anti-cancer treatment modalities. So that is the reason why in this video, we are going to study the cancer education system and the importance of cancer specialization. So the most basic training in medicine begins with the degree called MBBS, that is Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery. It is actually a 5.5 to 6 years training course, and this is the most basic degree of medicine. Now after completion of MBBS comes the second step of specialization. Now this specialization can be done in various other fields, but most commonly the fields which are important for cancer treatment are surgery, medicine, pediatrics and radiation oncology. So coming to the first specialization degree course after MBBS is MS or DNB surgery. Now during this 3 years training course, doctors are trained exclusively for treating all sorts of surgical complications and systemic complications related to surgery. The second degree is MD or DNB medicine or general medicine, what we call it as. So it is a specialized 3 years training course where doctors are trained for treating all sorts of medical problems related to all the systems in the body, that is heart, respiratory system, brain, or even gastrointestinal system, and all other treatment related to the systemic disorders. The third important degree, and which is very relevant for cancer treatment, is radiation oncology. So MD or DNB in radiation oncology is actually a 3 years training course where detailed education and training is given to the doctors for handling the radiation equipments, administering the radiotherapy in a safe way and also precisely, and to manage the complications or hazards of the radiation treatment. So the first basic arm of cancer treatment modality, that is radiation oncology, is actually a 3 year specialized training course after MBBS. The other two arms of anti-cancer treatment modalities, that is surgical oncology and medical oncology, are actually a 3 years additional training course beyond the specialization, that is beyond MS surgery and MD medicine. So MCH or DNB in surgical oncology requires additional 3 years training after MS general surgery, and during these 3 years, the surgeons are trained exclusively in management and surgery of only and exclusively cancers. The second degree, that is DM or DNB in medical oncology, involves additional 3 years training after MD medicine in exclusively cancers and management of systemic treatments used in cancer treatment modalities, that includes all chemotherapies, targeted therapies and immunotherapies. Now why this is important? Because chemotherapy is not just mixing and administering the injections given in the body, but it requires a lot of thought process which goes beyond the administration of chemotherapy, right from choosing the right chemotherapy drug or administering the right doses or adjusting or judging the medical background of the patient, and also to manage the complications which most of the times are medical complications, and that can be done best with having a sound background of medicine. So that is the reason why actually MCH surgical oncology and DM medical oncology is actually a 6 years additional training beyond MBBS. So in total, it requires a 12 years training course. So why this rigorous training is required? Now, you should understand that while treating any cancer patients, we as cancer specialists need to follow certain principles of oncology. Now, there are certain principles in surgery, that is, when to operate, how best to operate, and also when not to operate. For example, in advanced malignancies, generally curative or radical surgeries are not to be done. Similarly, there are principles in medical oncology while choosing the right drug, choosing the right chemotherapy, adjusting the drug doses, how to modify the treatment plan, and how to sequence the chemotherapy drugs. And that is the reason why each and every cancer specialist, that is surgical oncologist, medical oncologist, and radiation oncologist, has a specific role to play, and this role is not interchangeable because each one has a definite role which is very important for decision making and the management of the patient to the best. Unfortunately, in some tier 2 or tier 3 cities, this may not be possible because of the lack of specialists available, but always see to it that you take the advice of the right cancer specialist and incorporate their guidance in your treatment plan. So next time, if anyone is advised regarding any cancer surgery, please see to it that you take opinion of a surgical oncologist. If anyone is advised any kind of systemic treatment like chemotherapy or targeted therapy, please see to it that it has been advised by a properly trained medical oncologist. And most importantly, the treatment plan is to be made by a combined discussion with preferably all the treatment modality experts, that is surgical oncologist, medical oncologist, and radiation oncologist. So that's it. I hope this video will help you to understand exactly what is the cancer education system in our country, and also to help you to choose your cancer specialist and to know your cancer specialist in a better way. So next time, if any of your near and dear ones need advice regarding any cancer treatment, please see to it that they are in the right and safe hands to ensure the first and the best chance of cure. Thank you.